Good morning.
Good morning.
I see a lot of lovely, soulful faces out here. Detroit musicians are still alive. The big company went to California, but we're still here, still a family. I'm David Washington from WPON Radio, and I'll be your host this morning. And we're going to talk about the official Rhythm and Blues Hall of Fame that will be held October the 4th, 2015. And this will be the second class for this year. You're probably wondering, why is there two classes? Well, let me tell you why. There's enough artists that have made history that we could have two classes a year. The Rock down in Cleveland do it once a year, and of course, the Rhythm and Blues people are eliminated and forgotten. That's what this group is for, the Rhythm and Blues Hall of Fame. We want to recognize the people that didn't have the big giant records, but they made a contribution to the music scene over the years. And that's what it's all about. How much have you contributed to the music scene? And right now I like to bring on the founder and the CEO of the official Rhythm and Blues Hall of Fame, Mr. Lamont Robinson.
Good morning. I want to thank everybody for coming out this morning. I know it's kind of early. We've been really, really working trying to make this happen for the city of Detroit. And as David mentioned, we're holding two induction ceremonies this year. Kind of unheard of. We just had one about 3 weeks ago and down in Clarksdale, Mississippi, because we're doing the satellite location in Memphis. It's going to be held at the old Club Paradise. Some of you guys probably performed there back in the 60s. And you know, one of the things, you know, we had a great class. We had Millie Jackson, and she was on her best behavior. We had Barcades, Dorothy Moore, Denise LaSalle. My good friend Morgan Freeman showed up for me. Just a host of legends came out. Caught a little flack because I inducted Elvis Presley, but Graceland came, and the Presley family supports me 100% with this project. Last year when we was here in July, media went out that Clarksdale, Mississippi beat out Detroit. Well, that never happened because Detroit was always going to be the official home for this. The satellite is going to be in the south. So when that went out, you know, I catch a lot of flack from that from people here in Detroit, but we're kind of straightening it out. The Associated Press interviewed me yesterday. They were going to try to make it here. We asked all the press from Detroit to show up. USA Today is through the Associated Press, so tomorrow this will probably be in the paper, some of it. You know, one of the challenges that I have here in Detroit, I'm from Cleveland. I'm here 3 days out the week for the last 2 years and putting this project here. I could have went anywhere, Chicago, St. Louis, here in the north, put a check on the table, but you know, I've kind of pushed it back because I wanted Detroit. And the reason why I want Detroit, because Detroit is the rhythm and blues capital of the world. Even though I'm here from Cleveland, you can say it. And with me just really holding out, I mean, wherever I go, you know, the media is asking me, where is this going to be? I was in Detroit, we're making some great inroads. We had about an 8-month conversation, in-depth conversation with the Illiches. And what happened with that is that they got backlogged because of the arena, you know, and some of the people that they had, they got rid of. And they wanted me to wait about another 2 years. I just told them I couldn't wait. Then Dan Gilbert's group called me last week, and graciously, after they lost against Golden State Warriors, we was in the next day with him. And met with him last night. We really put some strategy together and worked with another group led by Norman Thatcher to bring us in. So, you know, this museum is going to be highly interactive, virtual reality, you know, and it's going to be great. One of the other things I want to clear up is that there's no rift between me and Motown. You know, I keep hearing that I'm supposed to be this new guy in town, you know, backed by the Ruffin family, and we want to take over Woodward Avenue. That's so far from the truth. When I first came into town, I went straight to Robin. I went to them and told them what I wanted to do. Part of the reason why I want to come here is because of Motown. But I must say, Detroit music scene was before Motown. You already had an international scene here before Motown. When Motown came, just exploded. Motown's the greatest record label in the world. Here's my buddy there. How's it going? You know, we really want you guys to just go out and just help us and put the word in people's hearts and minds that we need this museum. This is a tourist attraction and bring jobs. Somewhere between 250,000 and 500,000 people. This city needs this. It needs it bad. I would hate to see this go to Chicago, St. Louis, and I'm not. I mean, it ain't about the money with me. The Lord's taking care of me. I'm financially okay the rest of my life. And, I don't say that out of arrogance, but just out of hard work. And the Lord has blessed me. So I put all my money into this. I went into my savings for this. So hopefully, things will happen. We got this big event coming up October 4th, and I really like you guys to really support us. I could have went to the Fox, could have went somewhere, but I want an intimate. You know, next year we'll go out and we'll sell the rights to, like BET, a lot of people calling me, but I wanted to make sure that it was cemented first, and that's what we're doing here. And we sold about 100 tickets so far, so we only got 200 tickets left, and the tickets are $75 to the inductees. Of course, we can give you guys two free tickets, but after that, tickets are $50 for the inductees. So with that being said, Cleveland has the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, Nashville has the Country Music Hall of Fame, and Detroit will have the Rhythm and Blues Hall of Fame.
Thank you.